sister for us in prayer.
In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful, all praises due to Allah, the Lord of the worlds, the Beneficent, the Merciful, soul master's day of judgment in which we now live, the alone that we serve, the alone seeks for thine help and aid. O Allah, guide us on the right path, path of those upon whom thou hast bestowed thy favors, not on the path of those upon whom thy wrath is brought down, nor those who go astray have they heard thy teachings. Say, here lies one God, Allah is he of whom nothing is independent, but upon whom we all depend. He begetteth not, nor is he begotten, there is none like him. And I bear witness in none is heard to be served, worship, or praise beside Allah, who came in the person of Master Farah Muhammad. And I bear witness that the honor of Elijah Muhammad is our true servant and last apostle. Ameen.
Thank you, appreciate it. Assalamu alaikum. I'd like to say in the name of Allah, who came in the person of the Master Prophet Muhammad, the true and living God, we forever thank him for read up in our midst of the divine leader, teaching guide, and the person of the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. May the peace and blessings of Almighty God and Allah forever be upon him. Truly grateful on his coming and leaving with you and I. The most honorable Elijah Muhammad, who's no longer with you and I, but that what was given to him from Almighty God Allah, who came in the person of Master Farah Muhammad, lives with you and I, the believers. And we're very fortunate to be followers of the most honorable Elijah Muhammad, especially in this day and time, with everything that's going on. And our success lies in obedience to the most honorable Elijah Muhammad's teachings. This will save you and I, the followers of the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. It keeps us alive, mentally and physically. So we have to hold on to what the most honorable Elijah Muhammad has taught us. It's very important that we do. This is the life-giving teachings that will save you and I from the destruction of the devil, his wicked world of evil and indecency. But we're fortunate, like I say, once again, to be followers of the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. And if we look around and we see what's happening today, all this confusion, what's going on, the most honorable Elijah Muhammad has taught us that this is the day these kind of things will come. And if we look and see the confusion of the heads and states, he mentioned that also, that they would not be able to get along with each other, arguing and fighting among each other. This is the head of state. And we're very fortunate to have had a messenger to teach us and to guide us, and have a God who came in the person of Master Farah Muhammad, who's well able to protect you and I. And it has been proven he's well able to protect us, because we're still here. We're still soldiering, we're still pushing, and we're still implementing the teachings of the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. So his presence is here, and he's protecting you and I, so we don't have to worry about a thing. So it's a blessing to be a follower of the most honorable Elijah Muhammad. Praise be to Allah. You know, it said, and it says, you know, obey divine messengers. This is the key. This is one of the keys. It's the key. It's to obey divine messengers. Because when we obey the most honorable Elijah Muhammad's teachings, we obey in Allah, who came in the person of the Master Farah Muhammad. Because he's the one that chose the messenger to teach us and guide us. And there's not another Negro or so-called leader in the world that can take his place. I'll only choose as one. And you cannot force yourself on such office. And he has proven beyond a shadow of a doubt that he is the divine messenger. We can go and check history, but the work that he's done and completed, there's no other messenger. He's the last and greatest of them all. And we as followers of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad is blessed to be witness bearers, holding this torch and continuing the teachings of what was given to him from Almighty God, Allah, who came in the person of Master Farad Muhammad. And it's not an easy journey. It's a hard task. It's hard work yet to be done. It's the trailblazers, so to speak, our pioneers. We can't never forget the pioneers. The devil is always talking about his forefathers and what they laid down. But we have pioneers, that trailblazers that opened the trail for you and I, to make it a little better for you and I. A lot of them have given them their lives. They dedicated their whole life to Islam to see that we have be better for ourselves this day. For other world, we have to do the same. We have to strive hard in Allah's way, the Messenger taught us. And beyond, I don't care what it is, stay strong, hold on to Islam, hold on to the plow. The plow won't let you go. You have to let it go. So that means to hold on to Islam, that is the Islam is the plow, the Messenger's teachings. And he taught us that the worst is yet to come. The worst is yet to come. And we know that. But it's not a whole lot of pressure on you and I. It's not a whole lot of worry on you and I. Because we know this day, the Messenger taught us of this day. And so we're ready for it. We're ready for it. But we have to trust in Allah, who came in the person of Master Farad Muhammad. Because the Messenger said that in this day, children's hair will turn gray. It's going to be so much hell, confusion, grief, sorrow, all this. But his followers will be able to withstand it. Those who trust in Allah and believe in the Messenger's teachings, we will be able to withhold this and withstand this pressure. We as believers is under a lot of pressure right now. You know, but we're able to sustain and hold on in our everyday life. We're going through some kind of pressure. The devil always going to have his foot on our neck. He's not going to give us nothing worth anything. See what the Messenger say? He ain't going to give me nothing. So if he say he ain't going to give me nothing, he ain't going to give his followers nothing. Because we believe like he believed. We believe like he taught us. So we're his product. We believe everything he said. If he said a white man is the devil, the white man is the devil. If he say he always going to be the devil, and don't you ever forget it, he always going to be the devil, and we'll never forget it. And we're going to tell everybody he's the devil. See, because the Messenger said he was the devil. Now, where did he get it from? He got it from Allah. Allah said he was the devil. There's no truth in it. See, so we're very fortunate to know these things and to don't worry about a thing. Keep soldiering. That's brothers and sisters. Keep soldiering. See, before I go on too, however, I better say this before I get a little too far. We had our brother minister, Jabron Rashid, and the sister minister came. They had a surprise visit yesterday, came down yesterday. And it was a surprise. It was a surprise. I was happy to see him. You're always happy to see a believer. You know, you're happy to see a believer. And we talked, had a good time for the time that he was here. And said, a few things. So mentioned the paper. And he probably will be getting some papers. I said, all praise due to Allah. Because that's what it's about. Yeah, that's what it's about. It's about working in unity. That's the key. Unity is the key. So we must work in unity. Sincere unity. Not fake unity. Sincere unity. Under one banner. The Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad has taught. This is what we must do. And this is what we must continue to do. if we're going to be successful. And he sent the greetings from him to us, to all the believers here. As-salamu alaykum. And Sister Shahzad Ali, she sends the greetings of as-salamu alaykum. Brother Bay, Muhammad Salim Bay, from Oakland, California, he sends the greetings of as-salamu alaykum. Brother Harvey Shabbat and his wife, they send the greetings of as-salamu alaykum also. I talked to Brother Yusuf Yabaz out last night. He sends the greetings of as-salamu alaykum also. There's somebody else that I know of. But anyway, I got that out of the way. I thank Allah for all of them, because we're working together. Like it's always saying, the brother told me, I'll never forget it. It's not what always in front of you. It's not what's always out in front of us. See, you never know what's behind the scene. See, we have Allah, who came in the person of Master Farad Muhammad, backing us. See, but we're not by ourselves. We have more believers that's working, that's don't have a temple. It's not a lot of believers around them. We can see that by Brother we got a couple of people, brothers. Muti Kabir Ali in New Jersey. Mustafa and Sister Sharia in Ohio. We have a lot of brothers and sisters that have to go miles to see another brother or sister. And when we have them today, we can go right around the corner, down the block, around and see each other. They don't have that opportunity. They have to travel. We was in that predicament at one time, so we know how it is. We know exactly how it is. We had to do the same thing. Me and my wife had to do the same thing. We had to travel to and fro. We did it, you know. And I thank Allah, who came in the person of Master Farad Muhammad, that we didn't quit. It didn't stop us. Just made us work harder. And Allah blessed us, see. And he'll bless you too. He'll bless all of us with success. But your success, my success, it's all our success. So it's no little lies to be used. See, so this is the Messengers Program. Praise be to Allah, it's the Messengers Program. And this is what we do. We try to follow and obey his teachings. See, but we have a lot of opposition. A lot of opposition. You can't just say, sit back and say, it's not happening. It's happening. It's happening daily. All kinds of stuff throwing out. If we're not careful, it'll hit us and it'll affect us. That's why prayer, you must say your prayers. All these other things that come away, say your prayers. Ask Allah to strengthen us and help us and protect us and help us to be successful. Strive hard against the disbelieving hypocrites. Pray, ask him, so Allah, protect me and my family against that crooked deceiver who's always trying to put one over. See, there's a whole lot of things that we can say. See, and Allah, he knows our heart, he knows the truthful one. He knows who's going to be successful. We're going to be successful. We keep him and Allah and his messenger up front. That's the only way we're going to be successful. We can't be successful no other way. See, we have to love each other, treat each other right. That's the key. Brotherhood, sisterhood. Not like the brotherhood. What's like the brotherhood? What's like the sisterhood? Ain't nothing like that. We ain't gonna find nothing no better than the MGT. Ain't gonna find nothing no better than the GT. Under the guidance and leadership of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad's teachings, you ain't gonna find. I'm not talking about, I'm saying that the messenger's teachings. I don't know what this other stuff, if they're teaching like the messenger taught, they all right. But if they're not teaching what like the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad had taught and was set up, they ain't talking about nothing. That's just the bottom line. You can't find FOI, a brotherhood, no better than the FOI. You can't find it. You can talk on it all day long. See? But we as believers makes it go. We makes it click. If we don't click, make it click, kick out the nonsense, you won't be successful. See, you have these rotten apples. You have to always cast the rotten apple out quick. before they spoil the whole barrel. And that's the truth. If you got a rotten apple and he or she lingering around, she might soil somebody else pretty soon. See? So you got to nip it all in the bud from the beginning. See? So I know back in the day, feelings got hurt. But in the long run, it was better. In the long run, it was better. That's how you learn when your feelings get hurt. See, you learn when your feelings get hurt. See? It makes you better. It gets you away from that bag that you're in. See? So we put ourselves in a lot of bags. See? As long as the bag don't bust. As long as the bag don't bust. When the bag busts, you're in a little trouble. See? But you can get it before it busts, you can kind of get it real. You know how the bag gets wet under the bottom? It's wet under the bottom, but when it busts, that's it. That's like our stomachs. When our stomach wear out, whatever it is, head, brain, it wear out. That's it. See? So, but when it's soft under there, it can get back a little. When that foolishness dried, it could get a little stronger. When that foolishness, what makes it damp. But when you leave that, let it dry out like you put a bag up by the heat. If it's wet, it kind of dry out, right? So that's like truth. Truth will dry it out. So that's what I'm trying to say. It makes us look at ourselves. Because we make it go. We have a brotherhood. And we have a strong brotherhood. And the brotherhood is strong is when we all together. We all together. That's what makes it strong. That's what makes us strong. The message had one brotherhood. See? One sisterhood. And that's what makes it go. See? How we treat each other. See? How we love each other. You got to have this. We got to have sister. I'm not just talking about here. I'm talking about all across the board. See? Trying to run game. We got that today. Sister trying to run game. Don't say it. You have to say it. Get a garment. Tell her what's happening. The truth. What's going on. It's okay. I don't like to give you sides. A lot of them don't like to get a size. How big they is or whatever. They don't like getting the size. That's them. But don't try to run no game. You get the goods. You know what was happening. You know what you was told. So you accept it. You lied and didn't do what you said you did. So when you didn't do what you said you did, you supposed to do, you suffer the consequences. That's a consequence behind every evil deed. So when you trying to run game, that's some evil that you doing. That's some evil you doing. That's right. That's evil. You trying to play on your brother and your sister. In the messenger taught us, love for your brothers and sisters, that what you love for yourself. Now, put yourself. Turn it around and put yourself in that position. How would you feel? You see? That's justice. See? And it'll come back and bite you. It's going to come back and bite you. That's the boomerang. Allah is a just God. We can't treat the devil wrong. That's right. We have to treat everybody right, even white folks. We can't misuse the devil. We can't be no aggressor. We can't go and lie on the devil, although he's the father of the lie. But we can't just go lie on the devil. See? He did some good. He done did some good. The messenger said he did real good to show us all these years. To give us an education all these years. To feed us all these years. He did a lot of good. But he's still the devil. See? But that just goes to show you now. This is the brotherhood. It's just not in sisterhood. It's all around. It's not just no one place here. We got to be on the same page with the brothers and sisters in Chicago, all around, New York, but all around. We got to be on the same page. We have to have the same teachings for the message. The brotherhood, if we're under the guidance and leadership of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad teacher, it ain't no different from the brothers and sisters of Philadelphia. It ain't no different because we all believe in the same thing. We're all in unity when we're working together under the guidance and leadership of the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad. We're all in unity. So your FOI, the FOI there, ain't no different. Therefore, I hear we same teachings. I don't care how many you got. The message says some of them got 10 or 15, think they got 15,000. Walking all around with the chest all out, head swole up, face swole up. It's not about them. It's about getting the dead. That's what it's about. See, it ain't about you. You know, me. It's about this here. Waking them up. Yeah, the message said what? Yeah, hey, read this, brother. Look what Mr. Muhammad said. Read this. That's where it comes from, right? Is that see that? Plan to destroy our race. And he been doing it. The day he got his Mitch thing from Yaqub, he been doing it. That's right. This gonna wake him up. This right here, what the messenger said. And then we witness bears. We bear witness in this paper. So we can relate to some of our brothers and sisters. This is what Islam had done for me. What Islam had done for you. All this here. Got a brother in here, wrote this, what Islam had done for me. He telling the lost found brother and sister what Islam had done for him. See? And then some brother read and say, oh man, I went through the same thing. Same thing happened to me. That's why it's important to write for the paper. See, it's important. Pray through the light. It's important. Believe me, you plan a part. All of us is in this. Every one of us in it. When you write for the paper, you help raising the dead. Somebody that you're going to get to. Somebody going to understand and see why things happening to them. They understand the messages teaching, how the messages clean you up or clean me up. They wanted the same thing. Never been to the temple. Never heard anything about the messenger. See, the things that they hear all crazy. So we've been fortunate. It's a job. See, it's a job. Brother went out yesterday, got on. He's Brother Boy. Praise be to Allah. Brother Boy got on yesterday, went out there. See, he hit so fast, he didn't know what was happening. He's coming at him so fast. That's the way it goes sometimes. And sometimes you don't get nothing. Sometimes you don't get nothing. You might not get a bite. Like you go fishing sometime. Fish make you mad sometimes. Go out there and cast that rod out, you don't get a nipple. That's what you're doing when you take this paper out. You're fishing. It's not going to catch you. You're not going to get a nibble. You might not get a nibble. See? But you keep at it. You keep at it. Then they start biting, and you're going to, and they're going to look at this. It may not take effect right away. But on down the line, remember when that brother came to the temple, he had a flyer a year or two ago? Passed. He had a flyer. Had a flyer. That's how it worked. See? But when we in Islam, we as brothers and sisters, we have to truly, truly love each other. And when we truly, truly love each other, see the blessings and the success that we have. Everything we touch, you turn to gold. Because Allah is with us when we're working together in unity. When we love each other and we treating each other fairly. See? Allah blesses us. See? I never forget it. See? There's a true love that the brotherhood and sisterhood is supposed to have for each other. See? And it works. See? You love for your brother and sister what you love for yourself. You don't come to me, you ain't trying to put nothing over on your brother. You ain't trying to put a fast one over on your sister. You're doing things sincerely. You ain't trying to pull something over. Petty jealousy. You don't petty jealousy for each other. But you're jealous for each other. You ain't had nothing. You ain't got nothing. We got the teachers of the message, what blesses you and I. See? So how can I be jealous of you for what you got? What you got, if I want something in my reach, I can get it too. I'm jealous of you. Praise due to Allah. That's all praise due to Allah for blessing you. Maybe he'll bless me. It's mine coming, if it pleases him. See? So these are the kind of things. We love for our black brothers and sisters that we love for ourselves. You got to have that. You got to have it. We got to have it. Ain't no other way. If we got some heart, if our heart is hardened, you better get it out because you got to have it. You look around and you be by yourself. And you be wondering what's happening. And the only thing it takes is a few seconds to look in the mirror and go over ourselves. I'm not perfect. I go over myself, try to go over myself all the time, try to go over myself. I got a lot of flaws. See? But I, like I was talking yesterday, pray a lot that you're good outweigh your bad. I'm not talking about 50-50. 51. See, 50-50 don't weigh. That's the same. Your good not outweighing your bad. It's 50-50. Y'all even. Got to be 51. 51 to 49. Ain't that right?
Yeah.
All right. So my 51, I'm, you know, trying to bat. My brother said, if you're 51, you might be 45. So you got to keep trying to improve. See, that's what Islam is. It's improvement. We're always trying to improve ourselves, you know? Yeah, we're trying to better ourselves. You know, so we're not gonna be, we didn't got there yet. See? So we have to improve ourselves. And we improve ourselves by how we treat each other. That's one way to improve ourselves. See? Because some of us is better than others. Some of us is a little better off than others. You know? But we still can get there. Allah gives us what we need. It might not be what you want, but He gives you and I what we need. And we need this life-giving teachings. That's what we need. When we get this life-giving teachings and we work in this life-giving teaching, Allah blesses us with success. See, it's not about how big you are, or how big you think you are. You, Allah makes us great. He the one make you big. He makes us great. He makes us all great. Those who follow and obey in the teachings of His messenger. See? So ain't no big man. A little use, big eyes, a little use. We all together. We might have the responsibilities, might be a little better and bigger than yours, but still you have a responsibility. We all have responsibilities. Being a husband is a great responsibility. With a family, you got responsibility right there. You got a lot of responsibilities. We take care of our family. See? That's a responsibility. See, because we didn't know how to take care of our families years ago. At least I didn't. See? Look at the hair one. Foolish I was. See? These kind of things. But Islam makes you better. Islam clean you up. See? Make you get rid of all them habits. Drinking, smoking, gambling, all these different kinds of things. Islam clean you up. See? And it blesses us. See? Allah blesses us. So this is the key. The messenger's teachings. For we to be good Muslims. Once we're good Muslims and we loving each other like we should, we're gonna be successful. Yeah. Believe me when I tell you. I saw it work. Back in the day, we had a showed up true love for the brotherhood. I can bear witness. There were 13 lieutenants. 13. But we had a bond. We had a love for each other. We had good. Although, there was some difficulties a little bit in there. That was a little thing that needed to be ironed out. There were little hard-hearted in there. There was a little rebellious ones in there. That happens. But after a while, we worked it out. See? Because it wasn't one thing you do wrong. You didn't have to do nothing. They would do it. See? If they look for you to do it, what I'm saying, they'll tell you, hey, wait a minute, you wrong, brother. And you hear what the first officer said? Well, they didn't sit there and just let it ride. And it was good. It made us all better. See? And then that made him better because he stopped it. Because he knew he had better stopped it. Because all of them got on him. I didn't have to say nothing. Praise the Lord. I didn't have to say nothing. That's the brotherhood. They ain't gonna let nothing go. They look for you to say something or look for somebody else to say, no, they took it up. So wait a minute. You out of order, brother. Didn't you hear what the first officer said? Yeah, okay then, shut up then. Do what he say, do. Don't be giving no lip. This has happened. And that happened there. So it ain't all rosy, but you iron it out. Right. And they see, he saw, it's a couple of them. I'm first officer. It was a couple of them. I haven't said nothing. I haven't said not a word. And they get out, get all loud, get crazy, and act like they don't know what's happening. They say, wait a minute, what's your problem? I'm saying nothing. I don't say nothing. They go back and say, what's your problem? I said, didn't you hear what the first officer said? Yes, sir. He said, well, what you doing? He said, well, shut up. That's like that. Shut up. We talk about men. Shut up. Quit giving him a lip. Sit down. Do what he said, though. And he said, what happened, brother? I said, what's wrong with you, brother? All of them get on. What's wrong with you? You're sitting there looking stupid. Only thing he had to do was obey. But he's so full of pride and so hung up. Yeah. Okay. But that softened him now. Came back. Never had a problem with him no more. See? That's the brotherhood. That's the sisterhood. It's to show him, wait a minute, calm down, brother. Obey. It ain't about you. We all in this. It ain't about you. And that's what should happen. We don't have that problem. We don't have that problem. No. Because we nip it in the bud. We don't have it. No, we said, hold on, man. We ain't gonna have that. See? So this is what's happening. This makes us strong. It makes us love each other. It makes us respect each other. Respect one another. See? And you go a long way, and we go a long way because it starts in here. Our success starts in here. It's what's gonna make us steamroll. Because we love each other. We care about each other. See? We want every brother and sister to succeed. And we know with the teachings, if we obey the teachings, we will succeed. We will be successful. And that's what it's about. This is all this turmoil, all this stuff that's going on. Somebody's on the wrong page. Because the messenger teaches is plain. It's so plain, it's like taking candy from a baby. It's plain and simple. The messenger had, he drawed the plan out. He got it laid out. Only thing we have to do is abide by the rules and go forward in Allah's name. And we be successful. We come back and say, why are we not successful? We look at ourselves and say, what's going on? See? Do we love each other? You know? Do we really love each other as brothers and sisters? Do I got something in my heart against you? If I got something in my heart against you, no, brother. Why should I have some in my heart evil against you? Why should you have some in your heart evil against me? We won't be successful like that. See? We won't be successful like that. Allah bring in another one. He won't be quit wasting time. See? Because it goes in one ear and come out the other. See? We can't be jealous.